This is the Marketing Podcast Network.
Welcome to Uncorking a Story, the podcast that introduces you to the rich world of storytellers who share their personal journeys, creative processes, and the stories behind their stories, one conversation at a time. I'm your host, Mike Carlin, and I'm thrilled to be part of your writing journey. If you're an aspiring writer, a literary enthusiast, or simply someone who believes in the transformative power of words, you've come to the right place. Every week, we'll pop the cork on the world of successful storytellers and give you a healthy pour of inspiration, insight, and empowerment. My mission is to help writers like you realize your full potential through the transformative and therapeutic power of writing. Whether you're just starting your literary voyage or looking to refine your craft, I'm here to provide you with the knowledge, inspiration, and encouragement you need to embark on your own storytelling adventure. So, are you ready to uncork your story and let your creativity flow? Uncorking a Story is about to begin. Sit back, relax, and let the transformative magic of storytelling whisk you away. Welcome to Uncorking a Story. Jasmine Gonzalez is from New York City and writes poetry to reclaim the power over the aspects of her mental health that can spin out of control. Her poetry has been published in Lehman's Literary Magazine, in La Liberta, and in Spanglish Voices. She joins me today on Uncorking a Story to discuss her poetry and debut collection, Petals of the Red Dahlia. In the future, she hopes to publish more of her own writing to further help the agenda of giving voices to marginalized writers, especially those who struggle with mental health. Welcome to Uncorking a Story, Jasmine.
Thank you for having me, Michael. I appreciate it.
I'm excited to have you here, Jasmine, and I'd like to start where I typically do, which is understanding, where does your story as a writer begin?
Well, I was a very quiet kid. I didn't speak a lot in classes at all. I was very quiet, didn't show my emotions a lot at all. I just wrote. Then I stopped for a couple of decades, and I went back to it as an adult in college, where I found my voice as a really authentic, raw, emotional writer. I still don't speak a lot about how I feel. That's just me. It's in my genetics as well. So it's like, I gotta own that, my craft and my writing. That's what I do. It helps me get my release from whatever trauma I've been through, whatever I've been through personally.
How did you find your voice? Was there like a specific process you went through, or was it just by writing all the time?
I had a class in college, a creative nonfiction. I was told to write how I speak. So I was like, okay, I can do this. And I was like, you know what? It's on from here. I just kept writing and just never stopped since.
So it was this course in college helped you. It sounds like it may have awakened something inside you.
Yes, it did. Absolutely.
All right. Give me a compare and contrast of your life before and after this event happened. So how would you characterize your life before this happened?
Very honestly, I was very depressed. I was holding everything in like I usually do since I was a kid. I hold my emotions in. I was dealing with a lot of trauma with relationship stuff like that, familial stuff, and I was just holding everything in. And I was not happy, and I was just feeling blocked. Like my throat just felt a little constricted of emotions. And then now I can let things out, and they don't constrict me as much.
Yeah. You know, I remember studying psychology in college, and you know, you always start off with, okay, you know, the old masters, right? Like Sigmund Freud and all those. And you know, he and his contemporaries, you know, found out that just talking about problems or just talking about how you feel can change, you know, your experiences of those feelings. And it sounds like for you, you know, while verbalizing things might be challenging, the way you do it is through writing. And that's been like a very therapeutic process for you.
Absolutely. For many years now, I performed on stage. It's been more than I could be on stage, reading my poems on the stage, just getting them out there. It's even more cathartic. Someone will say, oh, I relate to you. I can see myself in your writing. And that's a blessing to me. I want to kick that door down for mental health. I want to kick that down, make sure that it's okay to not be okay.
Yeah.
It's a big thing for me.
Yeah. It, you know, that's a powerful message that it's okay not to be okay.
That's something that we all need to hear and be reminded of.
Absolutely.
Well, tell me a little bit about this collection, the collection you put together, Petals of the Red Dahlia. How did you go about putting that together? How did you decide kind of what would make it in and what didn't make it in? And let's go from there.
Well, editing was a very personal and very frustrating process in the beginning. It was very frustrating because I'm a perfectionist as an author. As a writer, I'm like, oh my God, this doesn't sound right. Got to edit this again. Holmes went through a different editing process. So it goes from my beginning stages of my mental health, like the roots of it, like that's like a blooming flower. So it goes up into what made my trauma and what triggered my writing journey, and go into the petal and into the stem, which is a foundation where I fought through my trauma. And the petals is my coming out, putting it into the world. Mm-hmm. That's how it's put together, mostly.
Yeah, I love that visual. It's so so descriptive. But in terms of kind of putting it together and then publishing it, what was that journey like for you?
Well, it is self-published, so I did it all on my own. It was a harrowing journey. So I had to keep formatting issues and just, it was a lot. I had imposter syndrome as well, so it's like, is it ready yet? Is it not ready yet? Can I really, really do this? And I was like, you know what? Some poems are really, they hit really deep. And I didn't want to have some backlash from people that I have in my family-wise and all that. But you know what? I pulled trigger and just did it. So it had to be out. It's my way of releasing how I feel onto this paper, into the world. It's okay to have these feelings. It's okay to wrestle with these feelings.
Yeah. And what has the response been since it's been out?
It's been rather positive from some people. Some just don't talk to me about it at all. So they read it and they was like, you know what? They stopped talking to me. I had to accept that. But this is my work and how I feel. I'm trying to navigate through my own emotions. Like, I've held it for so long.
Yeah. So. Some people just self-select out of the friendship or the relationship process.
Yeah, it's a deeper meaning behind the book.
Yeah. Well, that's how you know you're really striking a chord, you know, and you're taking chances with your writing. If people are you have that sort of a varied reaction to it.
I don't do fairy tales. I don't do that. I don't do fairy tales.
Yeah.
That's me. I'm just raw and honest about how I feel in my writing. I don't hold back. I don't pull back punches. I'm not going to do that for anybody.
So what do you think the big lessons you learned along this journey have been for you? You know, whether it's about yourself or even about sort of the publishing process.
I got to like be more patient with myself and be less hard on myself when it comes to my publishing process. Because I can be perfectionist, which I was in college for 4 years. I was hard on myself in college and in my writing process. I need to give myself more grace. This is hard stuff I'm dealing with. Navigating through, unpacking. So I have to take that slowly and with patience.
Yeah, absolutely. And then do you think you've got more in you? Do you think you have another collection in you, or maybe some
absolutely. I'm gonna take one in Puerto Rico. I was at there in November for a week. I haven't been there since I was a kid. Where my family's from. So I was there for a week and it was like a big thing for me, eye opening. I was in the rainforest at the water beating down on me. It was just very spiritual and very poetic. I have to come back and write a book where my roots are. But like I need to do that.
Yeah. So will you be writing it in Puerto Rico? Is there a long trip in your future?
That's the plan, definitely. I don't know when. It's going to happen, though. From my lips to ancestors' ears. We'll see what happens.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. Do you have any advice out there for people who want to do what you've done in terms of, you know, putting, whether it's a collection of poems together or it's some other writing project? Any words of advice?
Don't hold back. At all. Just write whatever is in your heart, like, or mind. If it's word vomit, it doesn't matter. It just put it on the page to get it out of yourself until you can cleanse what's bothering you or what's making you happy, what's making you sad, depressed, whatever is inside, just put it out there. Does that be ripped by everybody? Just be for you, just to get it out of your body.
Right. Just again, it's a notion of writing as therapy.
Absolutely.
And then you know, a lot of people who listen to the show are authors themselves. Any tips for kind of getting the word out now that you've got your collection out? Any words of advice and for people in terms of how they can spread the word about what it is that they might write?
I'm not gonna lie to you, it's hard for me to do it myself. I'm introverted and I suck at promoting myself, but social media is a big tool. I hate to use it sometimes, but I get tired from interacting with people all the time. So I do social media to just get out my poetry. I do spoken word on my poetry page without me on video. There, I'm less nervous doing it because people can't see me.
Right.
Or I just put it on a note in my iPhone and just put it on social media. It gets reactions. It gets, oh, I see you. I hear this. And it's like, do what's easier for you. If it's social media, go to social media. If it's doing your own like podcast like this, just reading to people, do that. Do what's comfortable for you.
Yeah, I think a lot of times, especially, you know, first-time authors might think that writing is the hard part. And then what I in my experience anyway, it's writing, you look back and you say, oh God, writing was the easy part.
Oh, yeah.
Promoting it is the hard part, right? Getting people
Absolutely.
To pay attention.
Absolutely. It's like, oh my God, I gotta do this again. Okay, I gotta do this.
Yeah.
My social battery's dying, and I have to get the book out and share this work to get myself out there. But
yeah, and especially for introverted people, it is a hard thing to overcome. But that's also part of the journey too. It's you know, if you feel like it's worthy enough to publish, you have to be your, no one's going to champion more than you are.
That's very true. Of course, doing my best.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, is there a poem you would like to read for us? Is that something we could possibly do? Or am I putting you too much on the spot?
Sure. I'll read one short one for you guys. Gotcha. Let's see. This piece is called The Mystique of the Red Dahlia. The strength in her stem keeps her standing above her demons. The deep red in her petals are her scars of perseverance. Reeling you in with her untold story, you might hear of her pain or tales of glory. A rare breed to find, but always a sight to behold. Best believe you want to watch how the mystery unfolds. It's like the core of my book, pretty much, like the middle part.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. How do you decide what order to put the collection in? Is there, because I think about like songwriters and bands, like they always spend a lot of time. Oh, this is probably more back in the day when people bought albums, but thinking about like what the track listing should be. Is it similar for poetry as well in terms of what order?
Yes, I thought roller coaster. So I thought like in the beginning, like it goes up, the rising action, then the stop is the core. Like the drop down to the deep stuff, and it's like the core of my drama, and it's the deepest part of my book, where it hits the most, gonna feel the most, and it's gonna be triggered with some people. And I admit that it is. You have said jazz, this book is a lot. I'm like, I know. I say take your time with it for that reason. Take your time with the book. Then the last part is the slowdown, like the little light at the end of the tunnel of me coming into my own as an adult, as a woman, dealing with my journey.
Yeah. I just can't imagine the amount of vulnerability required to do something like that. So I definitely applaud you for that. That's it's amazing.
Thank you.
Jasmine, where can people learn more about you? Do you have a website? Do you have some social media handles that you're active on?
I have Instagram, jasmineg.nyc, and I have a website as well, jasmineg.net.
All right. I'll make sure to put all of those in our show notes, as well as links to your books. I know the book is available on Amazon. I've seen it on Bookshop. Anywhere else people can buy it? Is it in any local bookstores or?
Not yet. I'm working on it. I'm working on it now.
All
right. That's a big thing I'm trying to get out there.
Very good. And any appearances that you have coming up where you might be promoting it?
I'm going to check the forum probably within the next couple of weeks in Spanish Harlem at an event I help curate and help organize with New York and Poets Cafe that I work for. It's pretty cool. I'm going to try to perform at that event, and that's just what I'm doing pretty much for the next couple of weeks.
Very cool. Well, be sure to send me those dates, and I'll promote them in our show notes and when I post this episode.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
All right. And anything else you want to say to the listeners of Uncorking a Story?
If you're an empath out there, make sure you get your release, because you get things that aren't your own, which I do as well. And just as an artist, whatever you decide to do, just get it out of your body, especially if you're an empath.
Get it out, right? Don't hold it in. Yep. Don't hold back.
Exactly.
I think we just found the title of this episode, Don't Hold Back with Jasmine Gonzalez.
Love it.
Jasmine, thank you so much for stopping by Uncorking a Story and letting me uncork yours.
Of course. Thank you for having me again.
Thanks for listening to Uncorking a Story. If you'd like more information about today's guest or to find out more about Mike, go to uncorkingastory.com. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe, rate, and review us at Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts. Tune in every week to hear Mike Carlin uncork a new story.